Hello, everybody. It is 1:18 a.m. Central Time on April 5th, 2017, Wednesday. Hope you guys are doing good. Just quickly jumping on here to let you guys know. A 6.1 magnitude, the largest earthquake to strike in North Iran in many months, if not over a year's time, has just occurred. And we can go get our station magnitude lists on this either from the EMSC or from the USGS. I'm going to go quickly open up a copy of the USGS just so we can see. And, oh, okay, I'm sorry. We have two 6.1s reported by the EMSC only at this point. Not a problem. We can go check their station list. Just as good as the USGS. Okay, we'll go. They're reporting 6.1, so we'll go with that. Check our station locations. Oh, wow, guys. We have 7.0, 6.9, 6.7. We have some 5s dragging it down, a 4 dragging it down, I should say. But we're topping out at 7s, 6.97. This was damaging. I guarantee you this caused injuries and possibly even some deaths, unfortunately. Now that we have a 6.0 striking in this location, this means Europe should be put on high alert at this point. If you know somebody that lives in Turkey or in Greece or in Italy, possibly even in Cyprus or Crete, we need to get the whole South Europe region prepared for an influx of pressure over the next couple days. Now, the 6.1 itself is a dramatic increase, even more than I would expect. However, there are deep earthquakes that are over here that have perturbed the area, swarms of 5s, and with the other 7s that struck, with the 7.0 that struck down here in southern Africa. This is leading me to think that we're at a time of heightened unrest that's getting equal to one of those other large earthquake moments, like what we saw maybe back in 2013 or back in 2011. It's getting pretty hectic, guys. Now I'm going to go look up this location. I think that's going to be significant. Let's go see if there's anything of any importance there. I don't know. I've never looked it up myself. So let's go find out. Inquiring minds want to know. And I recommend you do this whenever you see an earthquake that strikes of any important size, okay? So whenever you see an important earthquake strike, take the time, go pull the coordinates, put them in on Google Earth. You know you can get Google Earth for free. Go to earth.google.com. I don't get anything for recommending this. No www in front of it, just earth.google.com, and download a free copy. And then I've got the place marks that I've accumulated over many years' time. And those place marks come in tremendously handy when you're looking up some locations. Now, this location I've never looked up, so I don't know what's there, but just looking at it right off the bat, look at the plate boundary here. Do you see the shape on it? It's obviously splitting around Iran to the north and to the south. Now look where our red arrow is. Our red arrow right here on the screen showing us, obviously, where the plate boundary is on the north side. So all in all, what does it mean? It means new activity spreading to the west, coming out of the Mideast, and it means the people in Iran, in the western portion of Iran, going over into Turkey, should be alerted that whenever pressure transfers, it usually maintains most of its momentum across this area. So a 6 in this area can cause larger activity to strike down in the Mediterranean. Okay? So please, please let the people know over to the west, and this includes Turkey. This includes Western Greece, this includes Crete, and this also includes Central Italy. We've seen it so many times in the past. When a 6 or a 5 strikes over to the east, it causes a dramatic increase, not just anywhere, but where our plate boundaries are. The plate boundaries are where our red arrows are. So it's pretty obvious which areas are down the river from this. If you imagine this like a flowing stream, then you are downstream from a large deluge. And it's coming your way. So I want you just to let the people there know not to panic. Now, don't panic. This 6.1 that's here, that's going up to a 7, I think they're going to have to revise that. I think they're going to have to revise that one up. Let's say it's a 6.5, like what's down in Africa. That's a lot of pressure to be introduced into this portion of the hemisphere. It's a dramatic increase. Now, it's coming from our deep earthquakes over here. But overall, it means that pressure is going to be transferring further to the west over the next several days. And if you live in line of this, it's like living along a river. So when you know there's a storm up the stream from you and it's dumping a lot of water, you know that along the riverbanks and along the river, there's going to be a flood. In this case, the flood is going to be seismic. and it's going to be going into all of these areas: Romania, central Italy, western Greece, Crete, western Turkey, eastern Turkey. You are going to get lit up off this. No exaggeration. Everything that you see here is about to go at least one magnitude larger in each location. And that's not an exaggeration one bit. So please let the people know that's what's going on there. Also, just so you guys know, a few other earthquakes struck. The south part of the North Island of New Zealand was struck off the coast by a 3.2. That carries on with those threes. Those threes just keep popping, and that's going to increase. Also, Philippines was struck by a new round of activity. So Philippines hit, and Middle East hit. Southern Africa hit again. It's really, really picking up. So now is the time. If you live in Southern Europe, in the Mediterranean, sorry if you hear thunder behind me, down in the Southern Mediterranean, that is the point, that is the spot to watch. And if you live in the areas, you should already have an earthquake plan. I think you already know this. But now is, you can tell your friends and family, look, the way pressure transfers overall, just over the course of a week, let's say 2 weeks, 3 weeks, a month, pressure transfers from the Mideast over to our X marks the spot. So if we have an earthquake in between those spots, it's going to transfer across these regions. As it transfers across, it's a great amount of pressure, like an incoming tide of seismic pressure, which means all the areas are going to rise downstream from this pressure. Look where the arrows go. If you live in those areas, you need to have a plan. It's just that simple. And we'll get off lucky if everything just sticks at that one magnitude larger level. So everywhere there's threes, there's fours. Everywhere where there's twos, there's threes. We'll be lucky if that's all that occurs off this. I would say between Crete and Western Turkey in particular, there's going to be a real big buildup of pressure and release here. So it maybe not exactly equal to the 6.1, but very close to it. Maybe upper fives. Be on watch next 72 hours, 3 to 4 days at the most, 72 to 96 hours. Okay? So much love, guys. Be safe. Have a plan. Be prepared. Do not be scared. You can see the roadmap. You can see which way it goes, the pressure, and you can see what's up the river from you. That's the best we can do at this point, and the spots are pretty obvious. They're the fulcrum points. They're the spots that have been hit before. Just name them. They're pretty obvious. They're large areas, and all those areas, from Crete to Western Turkey, for instance, one 5.7 hits in there, it's going to affect both areas, so you got to warn both. Same within Italy down to South Italy. 5.7 hits in there, you're all going to feel it. It's just a matter of, is it going to strike at Norcia or is it going to strike at L'Aquila? They're about 100 miles apart, maybe at the most, 50 miles apart. It'll be back in central Italy. It'll be back in Romania, right at the bend of the plate where the S-shaped bend is in Romania. Let me show it to you. Back over here. Whoops. Here. At our S-shaped bend in Romania. That's going to be excited. Western portion of Turkey where the swarm's been happening. That's going to be excited. Crete, you're going to be excited again. And when I say excited, I mean we're going to see noteworthy activity strike in here in the next few days in between this region. Man. All right. Now it looks like they've downgraded it to a 5.7. What, are they working a couple twos? Now aftershocks. 5.7s don't normally cause aftershocks, guys. It's bigger than a 5.7. It's bigger than a 5.7. Let's go see. Is the USGS even... Let's go to the USGS site. Let me get a display capture back on here before I end the video. Let's go over to the USGS page. Latest earthquakes. Okay, they've got it. It's not on their distribution feed yet. That's not a problem. Okay, they're saying 6.1. Let's go over to the origin page and check the magnitudes. Okay, there's the one everybody's going with. Course, no details. Well, let's go down the low ball list and check the low ball list. 6.2, 6.1 at the top, and then we got some fours on there. Why don't they just throw out the fours? Throw out the fours. We know it's not a four. Fours don't cause aftershocks. Get all the fours off the list. And that leaves us with back up to 6.4, 6.5. It's a six of some kind. Now, they can do the downgrade game all they want, but I'm telling you guys, it was more in the six range. There's enough sixes on the list. 6.1, 6.3, 6.1, 6.1. Throughout the fours, go with the sixes. That's what it is. And look at how many stations are weighing in detecting six. So again, they always do the half magnitude downgrade. It's like politics or something. I don't know. I'm not going to chide them too hard, but I'm going to tell you, it's a six, not a five. And that makes a difference for what's coming down the river. So who's got the 6.1 on here? USGS now just reported in on their feed. It's thunder. Let's go look. Oh, somebody just brought up the antipodal. Let's go look up the antipodal. That's also one other thing we need to do. And let me show you how to do it. Search antipodal map. Antipodal map will give you antipodalmap.com. Pretty easy to use, too. Let me show you how to use it. It'll open two screens. Use the screen on the left to where you're going to look in. Look at that. That avatar is funny. So you look in at one spot, and it brings you out at the other. So let's go into North Iran and look in right here. And it brings us out where? In the South Pacific, down near Easter Island. Is that Easter Island? Where is Easter Island? The Pitcairn Islands? Hagnaroa? Hagnaroa. Maybe I should go look it up. Let's go look it up on Google Earth. Hagnaroa. Let's search that. Oh, Hanga, H-A-N-G-A, Roa. Hanga Roa Island. Part of Chile, so Chile owns the island, but look at where it is. It's way out here. Oh, that is Easter Island, look. Meow. That is the other name for Easter Island, which is a volcano. That is so interesting. So it's just southwest of there. I guess the nearest seamount is the Adams Seamount. Again, Smithsonian mark. These are all volcanic. All right. Hangaroa is Easter Island. There we go. All right. I'm going to save this as a video on my channel. Get the word out to the people in the region over to the west. Let them know something's coming. Man. Still got some storms outside here. All right, peace out, guys. Much love.